Welcome back, students. In this class, we will discuss about three topics today. Okay, already have completed first three topics. In this class, we will discuss about the next three topics. Okay, that is space diversity antennas. Second one is umbrella pattern antennas. Third one is minimum separation of cell site antennas. Right? First one is space diversity antennas. Second one, umbrella pattern antennas. Third one, minimum separation of cell site antennas. So, that is coming to the first one about space diversity antennas. Okay, you have already studied about diversity receiver. Okay, that is different. Okay, this is about the space diversity antenna. Okay, so if you want to compare, just go to the diversity receiver once, then come to space diversity antennas. So, in space diversity antennas, there exist two branch space diversity antennas, okay, which are used at the cell site to receive the same signal. Okay, so two antennas are used, okay, which are designed to receive the same signal with different fading envelopes. This is important. Okay, so with different fading envelopes, one at each other. Okay, so the two antennas are placed with a space with a distance d, okay, and these are intended to receive the same signal of different fading envelopes, and the degree of correlation between two fading envelopes is determined by the degree of separation between the two receiving antennas. So means the degree of these fading envelopes depends upon the degree of the separation. Okay, so the distance between these two antennas, okay, is related to the respect to fading envelope. Okay, that is the second point given. Next, third one, when the two fading envelopes are combined, the degree of fading is reduced. Okay, so here the antenna setup is shown in the figure 5.11a. okay, so this is about the antenna setup. Our two antennas are separated at a distance d. Okay, and the formula is given. So, diversity antenna spacing at the cell site, eta equal to h by d, where h is the antenna height, d is the antenna separation, and if the antenna height is of 100 feet, then the separation must be greater than or equal to 8 lambda, and if the antenna height is 150 feet, that is 50 meters, then the separation must be greater or equal to 14 lambda, right? And in any omni cell, the two space diversity antenna should be aligned with the terrain. Means according to the, you know, what's in the terrain contour. So we should have a U shape as shown in figure B. Okay. So if there exists in any omni cell, okay, the arrangement is as shown in the figure B. Okay. Next, and these space diversity antennas can separate only horizontally. Okay. Not vertically, only horizontally. Thus, there is no advantage in using a vertical separation in the design. Okay. So, this can be used only with respect to only horizontally, not vertically. Okay. Means these are not vertically separated. So, this is about space diversity antennas. Very simple topic. Next one, umbrella pattern antennas. Okay, umbrella pattern. You know how an umbrella looks. Okay, so it will cover only one specific region, one specific part. Okay, so this is a normal umbrella pattern antenna that is for controlling the energy in a confined area. So, you want to make the antenna or the signal in one respective location only. Okay, in an umbrella way. Okay, then we will use the umbrella pattern antennas. So, umbrella pattern antenna can be developed by using a monopole with a top disc. Okay, small projection as shown in the figure 5.1. Actually, the figure is not shown clearly, but here we have to assume that there is a disc with a small projection here. Right. So the size of it is determines the tilting angle of the pattern. Okay. So the smaller the disc, the larger the tilting angle. Okay. These are the tilting angle. Here there exists a tilting angle. And the size of this umbrella pattern, depends upon the size of the disc. The umbrella pattern depends upon the size of the disc. Okay, the size of the disc determines the tilting angle of the pattern. Tilting angle changes, the umbrella pattern changes. Okay, the smaller the disc, the larger the tilting angle of the umbrella pattern. Right. So next one, broadband umbrella pattern. Okay. So the parameters of disc cone antenna. Okay. Anyway, we'll show the figure about the disc cone antenna. Just we can show. I can show it. Okay, this is the disc cone antenna. Okay. That is a biconical antenna which one of the cones is extended to 180 degrees to form a disc. Okay. And means top. At top there is a disc. So this is said to be the disc, and this is said to be the cone. Okay. Disc cone antenna. As shown in the figure, I have shown just now. The diameter of the disc, the length of the cone, and the opening of the cone can be adjusted to create an umbrella pattern antenna. So, the diameter of the disc, okay, the diameter of the disc diameter, okay, here it is of 0.2 lambda, the diameter of the disc. Next one, opening of the cone, length of the cone and the opening of the cone, okay. Okay, length of the cone. Okay, opening of the cone. This is the opening. Okay, this is the opening of the cone. The length of the cone, opening of the cone, diameter of the disc. Decides the antenna. Decides the umbrella pattern. To get umbrella pattern antenna. This is with respect to broadband umbrella pattern antenna. Okay, first one is with respect to normal umbrella pattern antenna. And third one is high gain broadband umbrella pattern antenna. So what we are doing here? So a high gain antenna can be constructed by vertically stacking a number of umbrella pattern antennas as shown in figure. Vertically stacking means this is one disc cone antenna, disc cone, and there is a disc cone, a disc cone. Okay, so in order to create a high gain antenna, again there exists a pattern here. Okay, this is the pattern exists with respect to a high gain broadband umbrella pattern antenna. Just stacking all the disc cone antennas. Okay, stacking a number of umbrella pattern antennas. Okay, that's it. There is the equation given. Next, that is about the topic. That is about the topic, umbrella pattern antennas. Normal, broadband, high gain. Okay. Normal, we are using a simple monopole with a disc. Second one, we are using a disc cone antenna. Third one, we are cascading or stacking the respective disc cone antennas. These are about the umbrella pattern antennas. Second topic completed in this video lecture. And in this video lecture, the third topic is minimum separation of cell site antennas. Okay. So, simply we will discuss about the separation between the cell site antennas. And what is the minimum separation required? Separation between two transmitting antennas should be minimized to avoid the intermodulation. Not only intermodulation. Okay. The separation between two transmitting antennas should be minimized to avoid the intermodulation products. This is the first important parameter. Next, not only that, the minimum separation between the two transmitting antennas and a receiving antenna is necessary to avoid receiver desensitization. These are the important points to remember. First one is, we are using the separation between two transmitting antenna in order to avoid intermodulation, in order to avoid receiver desensitization. Next, and also to reduce antenna pattern effects. The point is given. Here we are describing a minimum separation between two receiving antennas. Two ranges. These are the important points to cover. One is intermodulation, not avoid intermodulation. Okay, not avoid receive desensitization. Next, not to reduce antenna pattern ripple effects. This is the third important point. Next one, the two receiving antennas are used for receiving antenna, with respect to receiving antenna. Okay, not only the transmitting antenna, with respect to receiving antenna. The two receiving antennas are used for space diversity receiver. Space diversity receiver, I already studied the first topic of this video lecture. Because of the near field disturbance due to the close spacing, ripples will form in the antenna pattern. Okay, here also ripples will form, but here this is also with respect to receiving antenna only. And third point and fourth point are almost similar. Next, the difference in power reception. The difference in power reception between two antennas at different angles of arrival as shown in the figure. Okay. So, difference in power reception between two antennas. Okay. As shown in figure 5.16. This is the figure. This is the antenna A. This is the antenna A. One antenna. The antenna B. The difference in power receptions is as shown. Okay. And this is the antenna pattern. A dotted line is represented by antenna A. And the straight line is represented by antenna B. So the antennas are located closer. The difference in power between two antennas at a given pointing angle increases. Okay. Means the antennas are located closer. So both antenna A and antenna B are closer. The difference in power P suffix A with respect to antenna A, power of antenna A. P suffix B with respect to power of antenna B. Between the two antennas at a given pointing angle increases. Okay. When the pointing angle increases, the antennas are closer. Okay. Although the power difference is confined to small sector, it affects a large section of street as shown in figure 5.16. Anyway, show it. If the power difference is excessive, use of space diversity will have no effect reducing fading. Okay. So there is a minimum power. Okay. Minimum power difference must exist. Okay, not minimum power, minimum power difference must exist. And here also I have mentioned about space diversity. Okay, the power difference is excessive. The power difference must not be excessive. Okay, power difference, the difference in power must be minimum. Use of space diversity will have no effect reducing fading. So here PB is greater than PA, means power of B is greater than at this point. Okay, at this point. So at this point, power of B is greater than PA with respect to antenna A. Antenna B power is greater. Okay, and at this point, and power of A is greater than power of B. And at this point, power of antenna B is greater than P. Suffix A, power of A. Okay, and these power differences must be in minimum. Okay, so that's it about this today's class. So in this class we have discussed about three points. Okay, three topics, very simple topics. That is, first one with respect to space diversity antennas, second one umbrella pattern antennas, third one minimum separation of cell site antennas. Thank you.